We'll start looking at eigenvalues and eigenvectors in this video. Let A be a complex n by n matrix. X be an n vector with complex entries, such that x is not the zero vector, and lambda be a complex number. We say that x is an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue lambda if the following holds: Ax equal to lambda times x. In other words, if x is an eigenvector of A, then A times x is simply a scalar multiple of x. Now, notice that by definition, the zero vector is never an eigenvector because we require the vector to be non-zero. Let's look at an example. Say A is the matrix 1, 2, 1, 0, and x is the vector 2, 1. Now, if you multiply A and x, you get in the first entry 1 times 2 plus 2 times 1. So you have 2 plus 2. And in the second entry, you get 1 times 2, that's 2, plus 0 times 1, that's 0, so that's just 2. And that's 4, 2. And you can express this as 2 times 2, 1, which is 2 times x. So in this case, 2, 1 is an eigenvector of this matrix A, and the eigenvalue will be 2. So the question that we are going to address now is how to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And for that, we're going to look at characteristic polynomials. Suppose that x is an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue lambda. That is, A times x is equal to lambda times x. But this can be rewritten as A times x minus lambda times x. But lambda times x can be written as lambda times I and then times x. So we can rewrite this as A minus lambda times I times x equal to 0. Now, because x is a non-zero vector, this tells us that x is a non-zero vector in the null space of A minus lambda I. In this example here, if you look at A minus 2i, the matrix is minus 1, 2, 1, minus 2. And the null space contains the vector 2, 1. So again, x is in the null space of A minus lambda I. But that means that this matrix A minus lambda I is singular, so its determinant is going to be 0. And the determinant of A minus lambda I is a polynomial in lambda. And this polynomial is denoted by P subscript A, called the characteristic polynomial of A. So every eigenvalue of A is a root of this polynomial. And conversely, every root of this polynomial is going to be an eigenvalue of A. So let's look at our example again. And this time we want to form the characteristic polynomial of A. So P subscript A is given by the determinant of 1, 2, 1, 0 minus lambda times the identity matrix. And that's the determinant of 1 minus lambda, 2, 1, and minus lambda. And expanding this using the formula for determinants of 2 by 2 matrices, we get that this is 1 minus lambda times minus lambda minus 2 times 1. And that will give us lambda squared minus lambda minus 2. Clearly, if lambda is equal to 2, this is 0. Now, there's also another root. If you set lambda equal to minus 1, you also get 0. So minus 1 squared is 1, minus minus 1 is plus 1, so that's 2, 2 minus 2 is 0. So minus 1 is also an eigenvalue. And what would be an eigenvector with this eigenvalue? Well, all you need to do is look at this matrix and find a non-zero vector in its null space. So this matrix is 2, 2, 1, 1. And it's not hard to see that if you take the vector 1, minus 1, this is in the null space of this matrix. So 1, minus 1 is an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue minus 1. Notice that there can be no other eigenvalues for A, because if you look at this characteristic polynomial, is of degree 2, and so there can be no more than two distinct eigenvalues, and we have found two of them, namely 2 and minus 1. So those are all the possible eigenvalues for A. To summarize, in order to find all the eigenvalues of a matrix, first you form the characteristic polynomial of that matrix, and then find all the roots of that polynomial. And to find eigenvector for a particular eigenvalue, you just find a non-zero vector in the null space of A minus that eigenvalue times I.